Why would he do that? That's the other big unanswered question, of course, said Shunter. Where is Andrew Tremmens? Chapter 11. Look, all I'm asking you to do is to carry on with business as usual, explained Blunt. The last thing we want is panic and a mass exodus of potential witnesses. A mass exodus after murder, said Mr. Stendish, leader of the village council. You don't know Agnes Crabb fans. D.I. Blunt had arrived in Naseley to take over the investigation and, as one of his first actions, had summoned the three members of the festival committee to meet him at the library, where he was doing his best to convince them to carry on with events as if nothing had happened. The committee was having none of it. I wouldn't be at all surprised if visitor numbers increase, added Stendish. Glenn's right. They've never been so happy, said a sharp-suited woman in a berry. Miss Imogen Olivia Clark was head of arts and culture for Bowster Borough Council. Our problem is that we're struggling to fill seats, said Glenn Stendish. All of this afternoon's scheduled events were sold out, but no one has bothered to turn up to any of them so far. Everyone is hanging around outside the village hall like flies around a, well, you know, like bees around a honeypot. Can't you issue a statement or something to make them disperse? Asked Miss Clark. I mean, just look at them. They're like ghouls. She pointed out of the window to the village hall next door, where a large crowd was rubbernecking outside the police tape perimeter in the hope of catching a glimpse of the activity within. Many were huddling in small fan club groups discussing potential theories. Others were actively interviewing potential witnesses and recording their findings in notebooks and on their mobile phones.